Hello. So now, at this point in your journey, you've already looked at water and wind and understood all the cycles that are related. However, if you remember from the first video, there was one last question that was very important. And that question was, why should we care? Now, if you looked at those videos, you understand that wind moves water and it affects how that cycles and how it moves the heat and nutrients throughout the earth. And this leads to huge global weather events and climatic events as well, like monsoons, like El Nino and La Nina, and all kinds of other things that you can research on your own. Now, you're saying to yourself, okay, Nathan, well, that's exciting, but why do I care? You know, monsoons happen in India. They don't happen where I live. And I ask you to consider this. What kind of vacation would you have if the water systems were affected so that you had wind changes and then you had precipitation changes? What kind of vacation would that be? But even more than that, if El Nino went crazy and out of control and the fish populations died, or there was effects with the agriculture that was going on in our area because of changes in precipitation, what would you eat? What would your family eat? It's issues like this, with food, and the very basics of survival that really affect how we live. So moving to a further question, what can you do? What can you do to become part of an actively involved citizen and a community to make changes? Just remember to look outside and to remember that with everything, there's a very delicate balance. And all it takes is a little movement to completely send it spiraling out of the way. Remember that you're part of that balance and do your part. Thank you for your time and enjoy your day.